answer writing matters the most. You have a lot of knowledge, it doesn't matter. UPSC is going to check you on your answers writing. So please, like for mains, keep focus on writing skill, writing ability. For your like now you might be giving prelims exam, I guess. So for prelims, pay special focus on knowledge and learning, but give your more time on revision. Revision is very crucial aspect of this exam. You will study, you will study 5 books, 10 books, that doesn't matter. You will definitely forget there. That's a real problem. So please revise at least 10 to 20 times before prelims exam, the entire syllabus, whatever you are having. Don't go into everything, just revise whatever you are reading, just revise it 10 to 20 times and do all the question practice. Multiple question practice, either you might have joined KSG test series or some sort of any question, do multiple question practice. And pay attention to that negative marking because, and speed factor. Speed factor in CSAT is very important. Some of my friends last year, they couldn't clear prelims just because of speed factor. Because they ended up, in GS they got 90-85, but in CSAT they got only 115-120 just because of speed factor. They were very slow in passages. So I'll tell you, for prelims in CSAT, please practice passages. English passages is very important. 23 to 30 questions you will get. Last year we got 23 questions. So practice passages. At least try to do 2 passages every day from today onward. After that, you will end up scoring really good in passage. And if you are confident in passage, your selection is sure. Because reasoning and math and all, they do. It doesn't matter much. You can do. But passage is a very key important factor. And after you clear prelims, your next step is mains, which is the most important step. And you might have seen the marks released by UPSC, the worst marks. So I'll tell you, it's very bad marks. I got the highest in India in mains. I got 796 out of 1750. And I'm the only student who have qualified in UPSC without interview. So I tell you, practice on answer writing. And show your answers to Apoor sir, Khan sir and all. They are really good. They will mold you where to correct and how to incorporate some pieces and all. But how to practice, that is important. So you will get a booklet from KSG. You will solve all those questions. For last 10 years, those questions also you solve. And in answer writing, try to have your own viewpoint. You might be reading the Hindu newspaper also. So frame your own suggestions and viewpoint and then incorporate them in your answers. That will reflect your originality and UPSC will definitely reward you with very high marks and for your originality. Now to discuss, like GS has 4 subparts, GS1. GS1 is history and geography. That is also, that ended up with very bad score. I think no one has crossed 100. I haven't seen any marks, like top rankers I'm saying, top 150. No one in more than 100. Even I got only 78. First ranker got 85 something, I don't remember that one. So there also it was very much accuracy was needed in answers. Questions are very simple, but accuracy was needed with your viewpoint and speed factor. Another first time in mains, speed factor played a vital role. People couldn't complete the paper, they left 5 questions, 6 questions. So I'll tell you, if you practice around 250 to 3 questions before mains, you will end up with confidence and then what will happen, you will not like leave any question. It's such accuracy and speed factor. Now paper 2, I think the worst subject quality and IR. I think very bad score, I got only 71, first ranker was 65, second got 64 and all, very bad marks. People are having 45, 50 and marks, only like that. So you will have to practice more and more, stress upon the articles and the contemporary relevance of the articles. Like the question came from anti-defection law. But you have not to write about what is anti-defection law, you have to write what is the contemporary situation of anti-defection law. So you need to focus on like what is the, you know, what some of the people have interacted with UPSC, those evaluators, and they said that we have been strictly told award 1/3 marks for the facts and how you present your answer. 1/3 marks for your contemporary relevance. If the person is only cramming and writing facts, it won't fetch him marks much. And 1/3 marks for your viewpoint, your own viewpoint, which serves your originality. That is important. So pay special focus on paper 2 is really, I think, I don't know, I when I studied, I never found that paper tough. But I got the worst marks. Paper 3 again, very dicey paper, science and tech, economics, environment, ecology. Study a lot because here your knowledge will matter. Your knowledge and then your presentation skill. You can use diagrams in this paper. It will really fetch you good marks, diagrams. In paper 3, what IAS Khan said, like, teaches all the diagrams and all, and contemporary that relevance. Like they will ask you on patent issue, ever bringing of patent and all those things they will ask. That is very important. Like hologram, that technology and all those things, you have to be very relevant and you can't write any crap fact and get marks. That's very much like clear. So paper 3 I got only 103 marks. At least it's very good marks because the first ranker only 85, second 87 like this. So people are having only like 50, 60 marks also. So at least get knowledge, write more, practice diagrams. Use diagrams. Simply, if you don't have diagram, make your own diagram and flowchart. But then, like some of the questions are really very pink revolution was asked. That was, if you don't know, you can't write, like simply you can't write anything. People wrote all this. It's a very good revolution, it's a really fetch, very like all this crap won't fetch you. So even I also wrote something. So that was like, I would be awarded zero only, I know that. And paper 4, again a really game player paper. I'm telling you, this is really a paper which can either make you to top ranks or to the low ranks, or no. So paper 4 I got the highest marks, 142 out of 250, that's really good marks. And some people are having like first ranker is having 116, some are having 1108 and all. But then paper 4 is very relevant if you have ethical issues, you have ethical terms to use, and then how you analyze the answer. Because if you had seen the paper 4, there might be 120 marks case study. Case study, you have to analyze it very well. Because whatever stand you are taking, you have to justify it. You have to write the merits of your stand, why you're taking, and you write the disadvantages also of your stand. But then, if you're refusing some stand, like you're not taking B option, C option, you have to justify it. Why are you not taking it? And in the conclusion, you have to write that this is the reason, but your take is because the following has relevance on people, society, and the country. The ethics should be also linked with people, society and the country. So you have to write this sort of answer, it will fetch you very good marks. You will end up with like 50% and more good marks. So that is paper 4. Optional, I think whatever interest you have, just study that optional. That will really like, because optional marks are very much clubbed. Like majority of the rankers are having their optional marks between 210 to 240. Majority, like some of them are having good marks also. So, but optional again played a vital role. Some of them took simply sociology and all, they don't have any interest and all. So don't do like that because they fetch only 120, 130 marks out of 500. So at least you have interest and be comfortable in your optional. Practice more. Do write answer writing more in your optional. You will definitely get around 250. Definitely. And 250 is a very good score. You will end up with 100 or under 100. Be an ISO. Now essay, you need not practice any special focus and all that, just keep your GS points strong and practice 3 to 4 essays before the exam, and just I think a class will also be held for essay, just learn that and just that is enough, practice more, 3 to 4 essays is more than enough and you will get good marks. But I'll give you a personal advice, don't attempt philosophical essays, like last year came Gandhian philosophy, be the change you want to see in others, something. People who attempted, I didn't found anyone ending with 3 digit score. Everyone is having 65, 70, 55 and all. So I think you should, if you are interested, you can write, but avoid that philosophical essay. Because they are very old faculties who check the paper. They don't give marks for philosophical essays. So that is more than enough. And for essay, if you score 50% is also very good. Now any queries? But please focus on your answer writing. Answer writing is very important part. A person have studied 5 books, 10 books of history, geography, won't clear the exam, and if it doesn't look at answer writing. And if a person has studied only one book, or not the book also, only KSG notes also, but he has practiced questions, he will definitely be under top 10, for sure. What I have seen, many of my friends who didn't clear mains and all, or final also, they didn't write answers. Like the first ranker, I interacted with him, even he said that even he was an IPS, he used to write answers, many answers he wrote. And then you pay your attention, even I wrote 300 answers and showed it to Khan sir, or a Kapoor sir also. So do that. I think IAS is the best job, it will really change your life. What you are right now, if you get into IAS or IPS, definitely you are changed. IAS is the best job, I think. Any more queries?
The strategy for feeling how you can use
Just keep now. Now I think only 1 or 2 months are left. So just keep revising now. Now don't study much more. Because you know I'm telling you don't study. Why? Because I've seen people who keep on studying and they don't hear it. After 4 attempts also they can't hear. So revise more. Revise 10 to 15 times. Because I'm telling you one more practical fact. At the exam time when you will give exam, I think you won't be confident for like more than 25 questions answers. Definitely. First ranker also is there. So you will have to use the elimination option. So at least revise more so that it may help you in that. So revise 10 to 15 times and do question practice. And wherever you are doing wrong, just try to learn that. But learn in the sense ki try to get the concept. Especially some environmental, ecological concepts and all, because they are asking these questions. And one more thing, there is a book called Vishal, of 20 years solved prelims paper, solved by. Practice that, 20 years paper. That is very, because you might have seen last year question came biofertilizer and some of the names of the plants were really what came in 96 or 2000, like Agaricus and all.
Which book?
Vishal's like 20 years old prelims book. That is really good book. Many studied. I saw many, like you should study that. You should solve 20 years paper at least, because now you have time. If one day also you solve one paper also, it's very good. So that is, and for prelims also that Vishal, that current affairs also comes. 1 year entire that current affair. So you can take that also. Those books, I think two books are enough for prelims. And reading comprehension by Alinam. That's a good book for passages.
Comprehension Alinam.
Yeah. And at least try to practice two passages every day. I'm telling you, if you practice two passages every day, on 24th August, you will clear your passage very well. Passage is really tough, but then you will be at ease. This is the prelims strategy. And mains answer writing. Keep writing. Jaise prelims khatam ho, start writing answers. Show it to your teachers or join the SIG that facilities are fun and all. And do answer writing on that. At least practice in your mind to have like 1 to 250 answers.
Any book for the GS paper 4?
Paper 4. See, there are many books, but I'll tell you a very simple book. It's a very easy book. It's Indian author book, very simple. But case studies is not there. Only concepts are there. It's Dr. Subhash Bikal, Ethics and Ingredient Application. I'll write for you. It's a very easy book. The concepts are given, I think, Learning India Publishers. Ethics, integrity, and aptitude. The cost is 115. After discount, you will get in 80 rupees. Yeah, we would even I bought that. It's a very easy book. You will get and very thin book also. You need not study so much. Because I know that like better of studying and all. So it's better to study simple book, thin book, and get all the concepts. But case studies is not there. So for case studies, you can have like insights on India.com, insightsonindia.com. Usme case study achhe aate hain, so you can refer that. And this is also a good site, ye mera site hai, isdream.com. So yahan pe main kuch upload karte rehta hu, dekhte rehna aur insights bare mein case study dekhte rehna. Wahan ke aur ye book padh lena, ye book you will matlab 5 din mein complete kar loge, itna easy book hai. Language is very easy. एकदम बहुत ईजी बुक है और मुझे लगता है अगर तुम ये बुक पढ़ लोगे तो तुम इसे केस स्टडीज खुद भी सॉल्व कर सकते हो. बस मैं तुम्हें बाद में एक तरीका बता दूंगा बट वो केस स्टडीज बना लेगा. फ्रॉम दिस बुक विल यू विल गेट वेरी इजीली कंसेप्ट, वेरी थिन बुक, इजी बुक, इंडियन लैंग्वेज बुक. उतना सो मच यू आई थिंक यू शुड नॉट स्टडी सो मच बिकॉज वेरी टफ टू स्टडी सो मच रियली रियली आई एम टेलिंग यू. बट फ्रॉम योर व्यू पॉइंट इसमें तो पढ़ना नहीं पड़ेगा, अपना व्यू पॉइंट खुद बनाओ. बैलेंस्ड ओपिनियन दो. यू शुड ऑलवेज हैव बैलेंस्ड ओपिनियन ऑन एवरी टॉपिक. दैट विल रियली हेल्प यू टू गेट गुड मार्क्स. व्हाटएवर आंसर्स यू आर राइटिंग 1, 2, 3 फॉर जो भी जीएस के पेपर्स का आंसर राइटिंग, फॉर्म बैलेंस्ड ओपिनियन एंड ऑलवेज राइट दैट. इफ एन इवैल्यूएटर सीज दैट, इट विल डेफिनेटली दैट विल बी रियली अपीलिंग. प्लस 1, 2 मार्क्स यू विल डेफिनेटली गेट.
This time in men's paper so many questions are coming on. How do you attempt to do this?
You have to attend that. That's what I'm saying. If you do multiple question practice and if you revise more and more, so you will be in practice. So I'm telling you one truth reality. Even when I was writing the answer, luckily I didn't left any question. I didn't leave any question actually. So you are not, even you can't think also. You see that you see question number 5. You can't think. What is the answer you will think and then you will write. You can't.
Yes.
If you think, you will end up with like 4-5 questions you will think, for sure. So you should be very thorough. And for being like, you have to thorough, like you need to have practice. And practice means like more and more amount of answers, revise more. You can use diagrams and all, pictures and all. It fetches good marks in geography and all, like diagrams and all will really give you good marks in that. So I think you should not leave question because it's very negative. And one more thing in this exam, it's a very long journey. I have a very big way of asking. So many times the negative thoughts come a lot. People do think like, even I thought like, hoga, nahi hoga, and all. Very uncertainty is there.
For example, you were earlier in bank and then you decided.
No. I'm a first attempt. This is my first attempt. Never in bank. He was in bank. First rank was in bank.
He was in bank. See, if 25% is coming in mens and we have, after doing 59 coming to Nora, I will not be able. So should I shortcut, should give lay census means in words?
You should cut short the words, yeah. That's your strategy, you have to. You know that you can't write so much. People and what they do, they start the first 5, they will like you beautify the answer. They will write so well and all. After that, I don't understand. So don't do that. Cut short the words, they are not going to count on the words. But make your presentation very good. Make your presentation matters more.
Yeah, consider on
it. No, I'll give it to you later.
You can upload
everyone. Yeah. Or you will get also at KSG. Upload it. Jo bhi likho, khanda se check karate rehna. Answer, upload it. They will tell you. Because you know, answer writing is the most important part because I myself have seen one student who used to study, you know, history, he completed 5 books, geography 5 books and all. Even he can't get mains also because he didn't practice a single book. He was saying, yeah, I know, I'll write. And after writing mains, he was so confident and he was saying that my paper was awesome. And he ended up from getting 300 marks in mains, English. So I'm saying we won't be in that development. Write more and one first attempt you get 10 months is enough to prepare for this exam. 10 months. Easily you can prepare in 10 months. Just write more and revision. If you don't revise then it will be difficult. Revision at least try to have 20 to 25 minutes. That is important. I'm not saying do every topic, do every sort of world history and all those. Revise, whatever you said, revise that. And any question you are getting, try to link that question to India's nation as development and all this. Like when you are getting French Revolution also, try to link that answer with India's development. Don't simply write about French Revolution. Try to link how that French Revolution helped India to get independence, how that French Revolution helped to inculcate nationality in Indians. Those things will matter a lot. How you integrate the topics also matters. You have a diverse topic of environment, ecology and all those things. So try to integrate that topic. Try to integrate quality, geography and all those things. Like one question, for example, El Nino. So El Nino, you know what is the concept of geography. Now try to incorporate quality also, that during El Nino what happens, drought and all. So under drought, some state failure across agriculture and all. So under some articles, under Article 275, the central government gives fund to land aid and all. So try to incorporate these things to reflect a very integrated person and you will get good marks. Then try to integrate ethics also. That this thing, so always end your answers with society and development of India. That will give you good marks. Every answer should end with, and hence it will lead to the nation's interest or nation development. Change your words accordingly. And answer should always end with nation's development. It shows you are a very positive person, though the question is negative. It will give you like criticize this. Question is negative. You have to end up with positive answer. And hence it will lead to nations in the interest of nation's development. So that way, you are a very optimistic guy, like totally you are for your nation. And they won't also, they will give you good mark. Because 46-45% you will get, you will be in top 10.
How was the interview?
Interview was not good actually. Interview is very subjective. Very subjective, you can't say. I faced Indian Forest also the same year. I got Alka Sirohi's board. She gave me 200 marks and I got 23rd rank. This time I got Kilan Sumla's ma'am board. She took my interview for 55 minutes. She gave me very bad marks. And just because of interview, I am on third rank. So I tell you, interview is very subjective. Nothing can be said. Interview, we do the parent video or trying to interview you can do. I'll tell you will get 150-160 easily, more than that. Interview is very subjective, you'll get marks. Main thing is,
can be referred only for the pre somewhere.
Whatever notes you have, revised that. First of all, revise entire polity, geography, economics. These are major contributors. Polity, you will be very comfortable. Now you will become comfortable, mains you will be having burst. In prelims you will get 20 questions out of 90 economics also, do that, very important. Science, do whatever you have learned here, practice core questions, test series and all. Like try to have, I think, 10 to 12 whole series of tests. Like I think KSG 5 to 6 you might have got.
Yes.
And try to get some more others also. There's a site of alshalfmantra.com. पर अभी पता नहीं वो करते नहीं करते हैं शायद बंद कर दिया उन्होंने मेरे टाइम पर होता था पिछले साल करते वाजी राम आई डोंट नो हैव इट यू कैन डू टेस्ट इज ऑलवेज गुड ओनली बट डू विद ऑनेस्टी डोंट डू लाइक सिंपली 5 क्वेश्चन प्रैक्टिस के देन लीव देन लीव दैट देन अगेन डू सम 5 टाइम डू विद ऑनेस्टी 2 आवर्स के लिए बैठ यू सिट डाउन एंड देन सिट एंड देन डू ऑनेस्टी नॉट लाइक दैट आई हम टेस्ट भी नहीं दिए ले पेपर जाके घर जाके बना रहे हैं बीच में कुछ खा रहे हैं नॉट लाइक दैट बिकॉज इट हैपेंस आई हैव सीन दिस इज अ थिंग ऑफ वेरी प्रॉपर वेरी प्रैक्टिकली और पे स्पेशल अटेंशन ऑन सीसैट बिकॉज दैट विल बी स्मूथ सेलिंग पैसेजेस रीजनिंग एंड ऑल दैट वो बहुत अच्छा रहेगा एटलीस्ट इफ यू एम फॉर 180 प्लस यू विल एंड अप विद 170 एंड ऑल देन यू ओनली नीड सम 60-70-80 मार्क्स देन दैट यू कैन हैंडल Because I know a person with whom I used to like sit and study, he was zero in GS. And we started our study around last March, or starting April, I guess, last March. Last March, he started and mid-May exam, 19th May, he ended up with getting 82 marks in GS. So I don't think that GS you can do. GS is, you revise more and more. Whatever you don't go, what happens like this, ye book, wo book, ye book, don't, ye sab jyada padhne ki zarurat hi nahi hai. Kam padho, lekin jyada achhe se padho, wo jyada important. Aur uske baad bas CSAT pe laga do, jo, ki at least 250 se upar aa jaye, ki safe zone mein aa jao. Because the cutoff was also very, very high last year, 241. बस प्रिलिम्स एक बार निकाल लो प्रिलिम्स निकालने में बैठे मत रहना कि यार जब रिजल्ट आएगा फिर स्टार्ट देन स्टार्ट ऑन मेंस कीप राइटिंग फिर तो हो जाएगा एक बार अगर राइटिंग तुमने स्टार्ट कर दिया तुम्हारा दो मेन हर्डल है फर्स्ट हर्डल इज प्रिलिम्स दिस इज वेरी डाइसी बिकॉज इट्स रियलिटी कि अब 600,000 लोग बैठ रहे हैं उसमें से 15,000 ही आने हैं इट्स अ रियलिटी इट्स अ वेरी बिग बिग थिंग तो उस चीज में बस थोड़ा लगा दो अपना जान उसमें कि 250 से ऊपर आ जाओ और उसके बाद जस्ट पे अटेंशन ओनली आंसर राइटिंग आई एम टेलिंग यू यू विल एंड अप विद गेटिंग अंडर टॉप 10 रैंक डोंट स्टडी मच जस्ट डू वन हिंदू न्यूज़पेपर इफ अ मैगजीन बिकॉज ये भी सच्चाई है कि अ पर्सन कांट स्टडी फोर मैगजीन इवन वी यूज्ड टू बाय अ मैगजीन हार्डली 4-5 टॉपिक्स नॉट मोर देन दैट पर वो सेटिस्फैक्शन वो रहता था कि यार बीडी ले लिए या सीएसआर ले लिए बट अगर आंसर राइटिंग में योजना जरूर खरीदना अगस्त में जब प्रिलिम्स खत्म हो जाएगा तो योजना बाय फॉर 3 मंथ्स वेरी गुड फॉर दिस आंसर बस दैट इज मोर देन आंसर राइटिंग करते रहो नो वन कैन एंड लाइक नो वन कैन स्टॉप यू फ्रॉम गेटिंग अ गुड राइट बिकॉज मेनी ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स यू नो दे आर गोइंग टू गिव नेक्स्ट ईयर आल्सो विद यू ऑल आल्सो दिस द सेम ईयर दो जिनको IAS मिला है, जो भी 1-200 नीचे रैंक्स हैं, मेजॉरिटी ऑफ देम आर अगेन गोइंग टू गिव दिस ईयर. दिस इज अ वेरी बैड थिंग, वेरी बैड थिंग एक्चुअली. यू आर गोइंग फॉर ट्रेनिंग IPS ऑल्सो, IRS ऑल्सो, यू आर असिस्टेंट कमिश्नर, यू आर एंड देन यू आर अगेन गिविंग. दिस इज अनफॉर्चुनेट फॉर यू ऑल, दिस इज खराब है. बस अभी पूरा जान लगा दो पीटी में, ट्राई टू गेट 180 प्लस इन CSAT. Try to like achieve maximum in CSAT in passages and all. Do your passages well, because I've seen majority of them do their reasoning maths and all they do. The decision making, try to attempt every question. That is very easy. Passages वो होते हैं, marks कम होते हैं, क्योंकि passages इतने लंबे आते हैं, इतने tough रहते हैं, और उसे question बस दो. अभी बहुत बेकार है, पता चला 10 मिनट पढ़ रहे हैं और दो question है. तो उस टाइम थोड़ा स्ट्रैटेजी बना देना कि अगर पैसेज, इफ यू हैव वेरी बिग पैसेज एंड ओनली योर क्वेश्चन इज टू, इट्स बेटर टू लीव दैट पैसेज एंड गो एंड देन गो टू रीजनिंग. बट सारे पैसेज मत छोड़ना, क्योंकि ये लोग भी बहुत क्लेवर होते हैं. व्हाट दे डू, दे डू सेक्शनल चैप्टर टॉप. वन ईयर अ गाय रोट वेरी वेल CSAT एंड ही सेड दैट आई विल गेट सम 170 एंड ऑल, बट ही कुडंट क्लियर प्रीलिम्स आल्सो. तो उसने RTI डाला, RTI में निकलता है कि उसने डिसीजन मेकिंग का अटेम्प्ट नहीं किया था. तो UPSC ने बोला, इफ यू कांट अटेम्प्ट क्वेश्चंस ऑफ डिसीजन मेकिंग वेयर जहां कोई नेगेटिव नहीं है, इट मींस यू आर नॉट एन गुड एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर और अ गवर्नमेंट सर्वेंट, सो इट्स बेटर यू डोंट चूज. तो डिसीजन मेकिंग तो कम छोड़ना ही मत, कहीं पे है तो ABCD हो, जो भी कोई नेगेटिव मार्क नहीं, वो सब लोग वो कर लेता है. मेन पैसेजेस पे ध्यान देना. और डेली अगर दो पैसेज बनाते हो तो आई कैन गिव यू गारंटी दैट 24 आवर्स यू विल बी वेरी कंफर्टेबल इन पैसेज. Out of 25, we will definitely be having plus 20 answers. Minus तो रहेगा ही, 3-4 रहेगा ही, sure ही है. In control रखना. GS में क्या करना है? Paper solve जब कर लो तो बंद कर देना. एक घंटे में का paper solve हो जाएगा GS का. Don't try to think and then mark. वो negative वो करा देता है बहुत ज़्यादा. In fact मेरे 5-6 negative उसी से हुआ था. I was thinking and then again marking, that all turned negative. जो एक घंटा बना 15 मिनट में solve हुआ, सॉल्व करो, बंद करो, सो. डोंट ट्राई टू थिंक, बिकॉज़ व्हाट हैपेंस इज द रियलिटी. इफ यू थिंक टू मच, यू थिंक हां यार ये सही से रट लगा देते, एक लगाया नेगेटिव. वो चीज मत करना, वो चीज रियली में खराब है. मतलब क्योंकि GS के आंसर्स किसी को, इनफैक्ट कोचिंग वालों को भी नहीं पता रहता क्या सही है क्या क्या गलत है. इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू कंक्लूड आल्सो या आई गिव करेक्ट आंसर.
You are saying for eliminating option.
That you have to do, because of you, तुम्हें आएगा ही नहीं question ना. Sure है. तुम मुझे बता दो, तुम 30 को question आता, तुम attempt कर ही नहीं पाओगे. वो जहाँ तुम 100% sure हो, you can't do. अगर कर लेते then you are a genius. But it's very difficult and that is the reality. जो मैं बात बोल रहा हूँ, it's not something I'm some fancy बोल रहा हूँ आपके. All reality and practical things which we faced. And I've interacted with rank 1 also and rank 9 also. They also said the same thing. Elimination process जो है prelims में बहुत help करता है, क्योंकि you won't know more than the questions you won't know. Quality में ही तुम्हें सबसे ज़्यादा आएगा answers. वो article से आ जाते हैं, वो कर लेना. Cooperative pentalism सबसे important topic है, वो सब कर लेना. Anyone ready? All the very best for your students, and I'll come again to teach you case study. Case studies अच्छा करना, कि case studies if you do well, you end up with some very good marks in the case. क्योंकि बाकी questions तो normal आते हैं, what is this, what is that, वो सब तो हो जाएगा. Main case study.